quick, Jesse, before the humans come, do you ever wonder where our food comes from?
Yep, I do, Jack. But, can you smell that? Oh my god, is that beef? Lamb chops? Oh my god, it's bacon!
Well, do you know where that food comes from?
Yes, Jack, sadly, I do. And when I was growing up, I was great friends with a pig, and boy, did she have some stories to tell about life in the pig prisons. The humans call them factory farms.
Pig prisons? Are you kidding me? Why do our humans do that to them? Plus, they say pigs are even more intelligent than us. And we're man's best friend.
Pigs are inquisitive and affectionate animals. Yet hidden away in factory farms, it's easy to forget that each of these animals is an individual with their own story. This mother is pregnant. She can legally be locked in a crate so small, she can't even turn around. Pigs have the intelligence of a three-year-old child. But factory farms condemn them to a lifetime of perpetual boredom, stress, and depression.
Oh, Jack, that is so sad to see the way they are treated. How I miss that pig.
Well, when I used to work on a farm as a young fella, I got to know the girls, I mean cows, pretty well too. What a great bunch of fine dames they were. And believe me, they too had stories to share.
Psst, Jack, stop sniffing around and come over here by the fence line. Have you seen my baby boy anywhere? The farmer came and took him away when he was only 2 days old. Now I give my milk to the farmer every day. Do you know where my baby is? He's just a few days old and he looks a little like me but smaller.
Sometimes I see a big truck come for the baby calves. Maybe he's in the orphanage.
Orphanage? What is that?
I think it's some kind of, like, temporary camp. Not the nicest place, I imagine.
Oh, Jack, do you think that's where he might be? I've heard some of the other girls talking about that. Some of the other girls said they've seen trucks come to pick up our kids, even when they're only a few days old. Even sometimes the mums and those bulls too. But we don't know where they're being taken. Do you, Jack?
I'm not so sure it's such a glamorous place. In fact, I've heard that it's like some kind of temporary holding cell before they, are sent off to be in cow heaven.
You've got to be kidding. I'm not hearing this. I've got to go and let the other girls know. Girls, OMG, this is terrible. I've been talking with the dog and you won't believe what he told me.
This is all just too traumatic for my little ears. I'll never forget the look on that poor cow's face. She looked so sad. And then that day, I started asking myself some other questions. Like, what about the sheep? Do they have orphanages? I hear the humans love them too, especially with mint sauce and that potato mash on the side.
And what about chickens? Have you heard about some of their prisons? Where sometimes there are up to a dozen chickens crammed into one small cage. Their feet never touch the grass. They never see the light of day.
Behind every chicken product is the story of an individual bird. The story most chickens share is life in a factory farm, and the price they pay is immense. Most people don't realise that birds like this one will be as young as 5 weeks old when they are sent to slaughter. Yet in these few short weeks, he will have experienced a lifetime of suffering.
This is terrible, Jack. Did you see how crammed in those poor chickens were? How can we ever put a stop to all of this and get the humans to stop this? What can we do to help our animal friends?
Well, you know, they say that humans don't need as much meat as they think they do. But if they do eat meat, it should be free range.
What's free range?
You know, like it's like where the pigs aren't in crates and the cows aren't in the factory farms and the chickens aren't in their cages. You know, roaming free, how they used to be. Like, look at these chickens here, who were in cages and released for the very first time.
want to cry, Jack. So are you saying if our humans wanted to still eat meat and bought only free-range animals who've had a good life and chickens who haven't lived in cages, then the prisons would be shut down?
Yep, you've got it. And all the animals would be free. And even better still, if our humans didn't eat dairy all the time, like KFC and McDonald's and ice cream and chocolate, yummy as it might be, and exercised more, then our humans would be healthier and they'd get so...
So what, Jack?
So, well, let's say unhealthy. Have you seen the change in people in the last 10 years? Eating everything in sight, like eating fast food, never exercising, sitting on their laptops and all over Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and Pinterest and other social media sites, every day, all day. And I hear that the humans are getting more bad conditions, like obesity and heart disease. And you do know that there are even a lot of our human friends turning vegetarian and even vegan now, and that helps our animal friends too.
Wow, what is a vegetarian or vegan? And what on earth is eating a plant-based diet? You mean the humans can actually eat the plants and grass and not the animals?
Well, kind of. Vegetarian means the humans mainly eat, you know, vegetables and fruits and nuts and yummy stuff like that. And the vegans, well, they don't eat or even wear any animal products at all.
What? Humans want to wear us too?
Where do you think fur coats come from? And leather? And shoes? And what? Well, that's like a whole other show. Do you know, in some countries in the world, they even eat us! They eat us as well!
Keep your fur on, Jack. So what you're saying is our human friends have a choice, and they don't have to eat us or wear us. And if they only buy free-range food or eat a plant-based diet, they'll be happier, healthier, not get sick, and it will help the animals and the planet?
Yep, you're a smart dog, aren't you? It all comes down to their choices and whether they speak out for us, the animals. Because, you know, we can't speak for ourselves.
Yes, we can. Look at us now. We're talking.
Oh, yeah. Oh, but the humans don't know that. And if one day all our humans understand this, we can all live longer. Us and the humans. The whole planet will be a happier place to live. And we can all be one big happy family. Oh, quick. Jesse, act like a dog. The humans are coming back.
Remember, kids, humankind means being kind to animals. All animals. They need you to speak out for them.
And remember, you have a choice when it comes to being healthy, helping the animals, and helping the planet. Will you help our animal friends, our planet, and most of all, yourself? Pause up, guys.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.